Welcome back. In this presentation, we are going to study about an important mineral or micronutrient, iodine. Iodine is an important dietary element required for synthesis of thyroid hormone. Thyroid hormones are, there are two, T3 and T4. T3 is called triiodothyronine or thyroxin. T4 is tetraiodothyronine. That means this thyroid hormone contains an important trace element or micronutrient, that is iodine. So this thyroid hormone is synthesized from thyroid gland, which is located in front of the neck. It has got two lobes connected by a isthmus. So iodine is an important micronutrient and an element or a mineral required for thyroid hormone synthesis. So we are taking this iodine through our diet in the form of iodide. So in fact, our body contains approximately about 25 to 30 milligram. The total body iodine content is about 25 to 30 milligram of iodine. Out of this, 80% is present in this thyroid gland. So remaining 20% may be present in salivary gland, maybe mammary gland, or some other cells or tissue. Coming to the recommended dietary allowance or daily allowance or dietary requirement of iodine is about 150 to 200 microgram per day. Okay, this is the daily requirement. Maybe in the growing children requires around less, that is about 90 to 120. But in case of pregnancy or during pregnancy, mother needs to take more iodine, maybe about 200 to 220 microgram per day. But during lactation, the requirement maybe increases about 250 to 270 microgram per day. On an average, for adult, 150 to 200 microgram per day. This requirement for normal adult. And iodine content of the blood is about 5 to 10 microgram per deciliter. Per 100 ml of blood, we have about 5 to 10 microgram of iodine. So this is an important mineral element required for biosynthesis of thyroid hormone. So this thyroid hormone is a very important hormone which is required for the normal growth and development. Normal growth. Even it is required for neurological development or development of the brain during early embryonic and fetal life. So when fetus is growing in the mother womb, at that time this thyroid hormone plays very important role, growth and development of nervous system. This iodine is very important for metabolism. So these are the some of the important functions. Why this thyroid hormone is very important? Because this hormone is important for normal growth and development of the brain or nervous system, metabolism of various macronutrient and micronutrient. Coming to the source of iodine. So this iodine is rich in seafood, especially fish, shrimp, seaweed, oyster. Seafoods are very good source of iodine. And soils. So whatever grown on iodine rich soil, that food contains highest amount of iodine. Green leafy vegetables, cereals, even water. So this source is mainly related to the amount of iodine present in the soil. It is depending upon the geographical location. So maybe some place contains more of iodine. So in that region, whatever vegetables or cereals grown, they contain some amount of iodine. It will be sufficient for daily requirement. Another source is dairy product. Egg. An important source of iodine is, nowadays it is iodized salt. It's a commercially available salt which is fortified with iodine, potassium iodide or potassium iodate. So WHO recommends about 20 to 40 milligram of iodine should be fortified with per kg of salt. That is what we consume, that is called iodized salt. And related to source, some of the food source which actually inhibit utilization of iodine by the thyroid gland. Such food source are called Goitrogens. So goitrogens are cassava, maize, bamboo shoot, tapioca and even cabbage. So here tapioca and cabbage, They contain an important chemical. It is called thiocyanate. This chemical actually inhibits uptake of iodine by the thyroid gland from the circulation. So these food, especially cassava, maize, bamboo shoot, tapioca, cabbage, they contain some chemical substance which actually inhibits utilization of the iodine, or it prevents utilization of the iodine. Especially tapioca and cabbage, they contain a chemical called thiocyanate which inhibits uptake of the iodine by the thyroid gland. Even mustard seed, it contains a chemical called thiourea, so which actually inhibits iodination, whereas thiocyanate inhibits uptake of iodine. That means uptake of iodine from the circulation by the thyroid gland. So functions we already studied, it is this iodine is required for formation of thyroid hormones thyroxine and T3 and T4, which is required for normal growth and development even in adult as well as during the embryonic or fetal life or during the infantile life. Deficiency, whenever this iodine is deficient in our diet, so this deficiency of iodine leads to enlargement of thyroid gland. This is called Goiter. This mainly due to hypothyroidism. This is actually in an adult. Whenever pregnant mother is deficient of iodine, then the fetus or the infant delivered with a deficiency of iodine, and it will lead to a disease called cretinism. So the cretinism is a deficiency of iodine in infant due to the deficiency of iodine in the pregnant mother. Deficiency during pregnancy. So the deficiency features we'll find in infants: mental retardation, dwarfism, all this because thyroid hormones are very much essential for normal growth and development. So in the next video, we are going to study about biosynthesis of thyroid hormones. For the biosynthesis of thyroid hormones, we require iodine. Is a very important element which is supplied from diet. So diet rich in iodine are usually seafood and the vegetables or food grown in the soil which is rich in iodine, and also dairy products or egg, they might contain some amount of iodine. So rich source is always seafood. Okay? But iodized salt is according to WHO recommendation, per kg of salt must contain approximately 20 to 40 milligram of iodine. Then it is called iodized salt. They use usually potassium iodide or potassium iodate. That's with respect to iodine. Thanks for watching.